OPF engaged in a bitter and public power struggle aimed at determining President Mugabe's successor. Grace Mugabe's rise in power unsettled others in the party who derived their legitimacy from their ties to Zimbabwe's independence struggle. These dynamics led to then Vice President Emmerson Mnangagwa's dismissal on November 6th. Military actions, purportedly in defense of President Mugabe, the party, and war veterans followed. Over the next several days, the world watched as hundreds of thousands of Zimbabweans marched in the streets and parliamentary impeachment proceedings began. Mugabe resigned on November 21st, ending his 37 years of rule. The rapid turn of events appears to have unified the people of Zimbabwe around a sense of hope and possibility for the future. The change in government also offers an opportunity for reform that could allow the United States to re-engage in ways we have not recently been able to do. In support of the people, we will expect to see genuine economic and political reform, including free and fair elections in 2018, in accordance with Zimbabwe's constitution. Economic mismanagement and widespread corruption were obstacles, making it difficult to engage effectively to address Zimbabwe's challenges. Deeply flawed elections in 2008 and 2013 further entrenched political divides in the country, diverting attention from much-needed reform. Nevertheless, the United States has maintained a strong relationship with the Zimbabwean people. Since Zimbabwe's independence in 1980, we have provided significant development assistance in the areas of health, food security, education, and economic opportunity for citizens. Today, our assistance builds resilience by helping millions of Zimbabwe's people battle HIV/AIDS, tuberculosis, malaria, food insecurity, malnutrition, landmines, and human trafficking. We've not seen an actual timeline for leading up to the elections. There was encouraging news that the period for voter registration has been extended into February. We are looking at what a lot of members of civil society have put forth as requests or demands for the new government vis-a-vis actual democratic steps. And we are working very closely with our like-minded partners and trying to remain in sync with them, both in Washington and Harare and in other capitals. We are looking at what a lot of members of civil society have put forth as requests or demands for the new government vis-a-vis actual democratic steps. And we are working very closely with our like-minded partners and trying to remain in sync with them, both in Washington and Harare and in other capitals.
Thank you. Senator, there will be efforts made by some outside governments and organizations to relieve some of the sanctions and to free up money or funding in the coming months. What will be our position?
While we're engaging with the new government with an open mind, it's not enough to say it's a new government, so therefore none of the sanctions or restrictions that were previously in place should apply. We will continue to look for signs of actual implementation. For example, the election that is coming up, there are months and months of preparation that need to lead up to that, and we would be interested to see an openness or an invitation to send outside observers, potentially as part of a group that might be led by an eminent African. And these are things that would need to happen fairly soon and could give some indication of the intentions beyond the nice speeches.